Greetings, my name is David Swisher and I'm the Learning Management Systems Coordinator at Tabor College. In this section, I want to take a few minutes to orient you to the Tabor Online environment, which will be your online home for much of your coursework during your studies here at Tabor. So what is Tabor Online? Tabor Online is a virtual learning environment where students and faculty can accomplish online whatever they would normally experience in an on-campus classroom setting. This web-based resource provides a means for viewing presentations and lectures, having discussions, sharing handouts and supplemental resources, taking quizzes, turning in assignments, and much more. You find it by going to online.tabor.edu and clicking Class Access. Now, Tabor College in Wichita and online has three main technology systems. We have our Tabor Gmail system, we have our My Tabor system, and then we have our network login system. This one, Tabor Online, uses the network password and your usual Tabor username. You don't need to add the @tabor.edu. That's just for your email, which is usually what you were originally assigned, and it's often, typically, just all numbers. Even if you have changed your My Tabor or Gmail password, your network password seldom changes unless you have asked our IT office to do that. I often get asked what the difference is between My Tabor and Tabor Online, so let me explain. My Tabor is what you get when you go to www.tabor.edu and click the My Tabor button at the top bar along the top of the page. That's your personalized portal on tabor.edu for everything involving your studies at college. This is where you can find information about what you're enrolled in, your financial aid, your bills, your final grades, etc. In our upcoming sections, Misty and Amanda will both walk you through how to use the personalized information that's found there. However, your classes are not housed there. You'll find all of your online course content in Tabor Online. Tabor Online is found by going to online.tabor.edu and clicking Class Access. If you happen to be in My Tabor and you click a list of the courses you're enrolled in, you'll notice that those are links, but those links go to an area of My Tabor that we no longer use. So make sure whenever you're looking for your class content that you're going to online.tabor.edu and clicking Class Access. So here's how that looks when you go to online.tabor.edu. This site brings all of our online learning technologies into one central place. So if you can remember that address, online.tabor.edu, you can find everything you need. For resources like My Tabor, the library, your Tabor Gmail, etc., simply click the link under Student Resources down here at the bottom to find the listing of all of those quick links to those resources. For any online class content, just click either of the class access links on this page. One of them is right above it here that says class access. The other one is right up at the top, class access. So let's do that now. So here we have our Tabor Online site. We'll click the class access button. And you'll notice two places to log in. You can do it in the upper right-hand corner, or there's another one down here. I will enter my username and my password. And now we are into the course content portion of our Tabor Online site. These are the courses that I am enrolled in. So how do you find your course? Well, most of the time your courses are going to be listed right here on the homepage under My Courses. You'll typically see just the ones that you're already enrolled in so far. Anything that's coming up won't be listed there, just those that are available to you. You'll see them listed right here. However, you can also find them in a block over here on the left called My Courses. So if for some reason you don't see it here, you can scroll down through this list and find them. And there is a search tool, so you can always do it this way. And that's a quick and easy way to find one specific course. So how do you view and download files? Let's take a look at that. A variety of types of resources can be posted on your course's homepage, such as PowerPoint files, Word documents, links to websites and web-based resources, videos, and more. To access any of these resources, simply click the link. So if you see what looks like a PDF symbol and you click that, that will open up a PDF. And depending on which version of Word and your browser you're using, It will either immediately pop up and ask you what you want to do with it, whether you want to save it or view it, or the version I'm using here moves everything to my download folder. So here it is, and I can double click that, and there it is. Some of the resources are interactive flashcards, and here's what that looks like. Click it, and it opens up the browser-based study system. Use that kind of for a glossary review. Other resources will open up just by clicking it this way. Now, here you go. These are reading assignments. Some of our courses have the lesson content in PowerPoint slides that have been converted to Adobe Presenter, and you'll see that this way. You'll click the PowerPoint slides link, and now it has your specific chapter ones. There we go. So this would be what a presentation looks like within that format. You can click play to advance between slides. You can also jump between sections, like if you're along in here and you need to go back to a previous one, you can click here, and it tells you how long. In this case, there's no recorded audio or video content, so everything's just one click, but we could use voiceovers or video, and you would navigate through the lesson content that way. So how do you participate in an online discussion? In Tabor Online, you can have classroom discussions, collaborate on projects, and hang out virtually through discussion forums. Your instructor will often assign you to complete certain discussions and discuss various topics. Here's an example of how you would do that. You look for one of these icons that has a little talking bubble symbol. You click that link, and now we have the discussion. So at the top of this here, what you're seeing here is what we're being asked to do, what the actual assignment is here in this case. If there's a particular rubric that's involved of what's expected, we would click that to see that information. And here it downloaded it for me. Okay. And if no one else has posted yet, I'll be the first. So I click this button that says add a new discussion topic. And then a form comes up, and I will just type in, here's what I think. These are my thoughts, and if I want to be subscribed to everyone who responds, I can click leave it at the default, send me email copies of posts. If I don't want to get constant emails from everybody who's responded, then I would click that button. If I have something I want to attach, I would simply click add, and then I would search my computer for a file, click browse. And let's see, I think I saved it on my desktop. And here we go. There's my document. And there's my name, so then I'll upload the file. And now you'll see I have my subject line. I have the things I wanted to share. Obviously yours would be a little bit more extensive than this. And then there's the file I wanted to attach, and I'll post that to the forum. It makes a note here that I have 30 minutes to edit if I want, so you can edit for 30 minutes, but obviously if you post and somebody else responds before you've edited, it can cause a little bit of confusion, so try to avoid that. And then here we go. We now have my first post, and so if I were to click that, let's say this is a classmate's, I'll click it. That lets my classmates see it, and then any of my classmates can then go click reply. And I'll say, great idea, what about X? Post to forum. And now we're seeing basically a hierarchical discussion. We have the initial comment, we have the response comment. And so as you have your discussions in class, you'll find multiple layers of complexity of different ones of you. Give comments and share ideas and give feedback back and forth, and that's a great way to have our online discussions. You can also add things, formatting, like here I'll just give you an example, bold, italics, large, etc. So if I highlight here's the tools here for that bold. Here would be the italics. Here would be the large. I can make things be bullets by clicking this, or numbered. If I need to include a hyperlink to something, let's say I have a particular website, I just highlight the text, and now see the tools here came up to turn that into a hyperlink. And we'll make that one go to the Bible Gateway passage. How about that? And if I need to include a picture, I can do that. It's the same process there. I would find or upload an image, browse for it. I think I left it on the desktop as well. There we go. And I'm going to upload. And there it is, and I'll insert it. So now that appears. It's kind of hard to see, because there it is. It's rather large, so I could always shrink it down just a bit. But for the sake of time, I'll just go ahead and post a forum. So now you see my initial post, follow-up response, and then this one here we just did with my attached image. Okay, so how do I submit an assignment? You can turn in your papers and projects electronically. In Tabor Online, there's no need to email them. You can do it right through the system. Exactly how you do this varies depending on the type of assignment, but most of them will follow this method. You'll scroll down through the course to find one of these assignment upload links. They are indicated by a paper symbol with a hand, which indicates that you're handing in a particular paper. And you click that link. And now we have the assignment instructions. Anything that's posted in here are the instructions we're supposed to follow. So make sure you take a close look at that. And it gives me an overview of my submission status. Now this is just a sample for an old course, so that's why it's overdue. But you would want to pay attention to the due date and how long you have to submit it. And you would click Add Submission. This pulls up a utility where you can search for the file. So the assumption is you have already written up your paper or your response in something like Word or PowerPoint, or maybe you've saved it as a PDF or as an image, whatever the assignment calls for. And then what you're doing here is actually looking for that file. So I'll click Add. I'll browse for that particular file, which I think I saved on my desktop. And there's my files. All right. And here it is. I will click Input. Now let's put it in the holding bin there, and then I will upload this file. So it's been uploaded, but not yet submitted. Now when I click Save Changes, I just submitted my assignment to my instructor. And it says my submission status is now submitted for grading. And when it was submitted, there's the file. If I need to go back and look at it, and there's even the time and date stamp. Now, later, if I need to go back to something, or let's say I forgot to add a second file or something like that, I can always edit my submission. Just keep in mind that everything you do in the system will be time and date stamped, so your instructor will know when you turn something in. And that's all you have to do. So, how do I check my grades? If your instructor is using Tabor Online to track grades, which most of them are, you can check your progress and any feedback they've offered this way. You'll go to, over on the left-hand side, under Settings, there's Grades. And here's a list of all the assignments and discussions that appear in the course. And they're by category, so these match up to the syllabus. So the participation is one category in the syllabus. And here's everything that counts toward that. Here's the second category in the syllabus, the APA library exercises, and the assignments that contribute to that. Again, and so you can see the whole picture of the course, and as I turn in assignments, then the or complete quiz, like here's a quiz right here, my score will appear right here as a grade and then as a percentage. If my instructor has given me feedback, it's going to appear right out here on the right-hand side under feedback. And for any particular item, for example, if the feedback is more than a phrase or a sentence long, which it typically would be, I can always click the particular link. And then, of course, I haven't submitted one here, but if I click the assignment item right there, then my instructor's feedback would appear in a dialog box, so I could respond to it that way. And then at the very bottom would be the course total. But I do want to point out, this course total is only a calculation of what you have done and completed so far. So, for example, if there's 1,000 points in the course and you're only in week 2 and you've only completed 200 points of that 1,000, it's going to say you're not making a very good grade yet, but that doesn't mean you're failing. What it means is you've only completed 200 points out of the 1,000 so far. So you look at the ones you've done and what they were worth, and here it indicates it. So this one was worth 25, this one was worth 40, this one's worth 28, etc. And you just keep tabs on how you're doing along the way. At the very end of the course, after everything's done and turned in and submitted, your instructor will submit their final grades, and those will actually go to the My Tabor system. So you would log into My Tabor, that's a separate site, and look up your final grades there. But all along the way, this system gives you a status, and kind of like a progress report of how you're doing. And you can kind of gauge when you're in week 3 and in week 4, well, I've done so well on this, but not this, and you can kind of gauge what you need to do differently in the final weeks to make sure you get the grade that you're looking for. And the last thing I want to talk about is, how do you email your instructor and your classmates? Well, the good news is you don't even have to use a separate email system. You can do that right from within the course. You can see who else is in your course and also send an email to either your instructor or your classmates or to all of them. Here's how you would do it. You would go down along the left-hand side until you see the block that's labeled Quick Mail, and you click Compose New Email, and this keeps track of everybody who's in your class. So here's all the classmates, and let's say I want to send one to Kayla, I would click Add. If I want to send one to Jennifer and Abby, all I did was I held down the Control key to select or deselect one, Add. And then I would simply go down here and start typing my message. And you can use the same controls here that you found in the discussion forum for bolds, italics, bullets, numbers, adding hyperlinks or attachments or emails or images. Now notice one thing here. It says receive a copy, yes or no. If you send something through this system, I would recommend every time that you actually click yes to receive a copy, because then you have a record of what you sent. It does not usually make it easy for you to retrieve a copy of something that you've sent. So clicking yes to receive a copy is the best way. It will be sent to your favorite email address. And then we click send email. That's all there is to it. So who do you call if there's a problem? Simple. For any problems that are technical in nature, in other words, if you can't do or can't figure out how or can't even remember how to do something in the course, contact the 24/7 help desk. You can find that in any course by looking for the Live Support Online button. It looks just like this. This help desk is available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and can be reached using phone, email, or live chat. So if you're having problems downloading a file, uploading an assignment, attaching to a discussion, checking how you did on a particular assignment, opening a media file, or anything like that, the 24/7 help desk is your go-to solution. If your question pertains to the course itself, something which isn't clear about what's expected of you, contact your instructor. You'll find your instructor's contact information at the front of your syllabus. If you're having issues or problems with logging into the site, however, the 24/7 help desk won't be able to assist with that because it's a Tabor-specific issue. For that, just contact our LMS coordinator, which is me, David Swisher. You can reach me at taborlms@tabor.edu or by calling the main Wichita office at 316-729-6333 and asking for me, or extension 2216. If I'm unavailable, I usually provide alternate options in an auto-reply to my email, so email is always a great way to get a hold of me. But a backup solution for login issues would be to ask for Misty Smithson, or you can email networkhelp@tabor.edu. All of us are glad to help. I hope this information has been helpful for you. If you need additional information or if I can help in any other way, please contact me at the information shown above.